Dairy farming is one of the main sources of local food production. Farmers work arduous hours every day to bring fresh and healthful milk products to consumers. The emergence of larger, more industrialized dairy farms puts family-run farms at risk for survival. Many consumers are worried that our food is being processed by large conglomerates, but the truth is that family operations can't survive without the relations to these companies. Hilton Dairy Farm is a family operation located on a quiet street in Canandaigua, New York, run by two generations of experienced farmers.
And my name is Lisa Greffereth, and I work here full-time at the dairy. My main role is herds person. I'm in charge of all the cow health for our 400-cow dairy. Everything from making sure they get fed, milked, and any sicknesses I have to treat, along with I'm in charge of all the farm labor and the barn end, and reproduction.
I'm Margaret Hilton. Many people know me as Peggy. That was a nickname given me as a child. And my husband and I own Hilton Farms, which we operate with our son and daughter-in-law and our son. And on the farm, on my role is, besides being the housewife, I keep all of the books and do the payroll for the farm. In past years, when we were a little bit smaller, I did feed calves and drive tractor occasionally. And that's pretty much a role of a farm wife. You kind of chip in whenever it's needed.
Hilton Dairy Farm operates with 400 female cows. Each cow receives close attention and care from the different workers on the farm.
My name is Tom Greffereth, and I am part of the family here at Hilton Farms. I'm the son-in-law, Lisa's my wife, and pretty much what my responsibilities and job here is to feed the cows, help maintain herd health, and pretty much anything else that needs to be done.
We milk approximately 380 cows three times a day. We milk at 6 in the morning, 2 in the afternoon, and 10 at night. Milking shift with setup and cleanup included is about 6 hours.
The milk does not go to bottles for drinking. It instead travels to craft factories where it is used to make cheese.
We're a member of a milk co-op, and we are a member of a smaller co-op. We have a contract with Kraft at this time, and they market our milk, take our milk, and it is produced as cheese.
Kraft mac and cheese. It's the cheesiest.
Industrial farming began to emerge in the 1920s. The farms were efficient, highly planned, and relied on experts to carry out large-scale operations. Over the decades, the United States has become a country of mass production, mastering the large-scale farming industry. Today, family farmers are being forced out of business. In the 1930s, there were roughly 7 million farms, compared to 2 million today. And of the 2 million currently in operation, only about 3.5% are family-run.
Dairy business has changed dramatically from my parents, from my grandparents. It's no longer just a mom and dad family farm. It's more of a business.
Here in California, we've had to expand because you just have to get larger or you can't compete with the big guys. And I think that the smaller guys, if they really are serious about staying in the business, if they'll learn and watch and the efficient tools and ideas that the larger guys have and implement them in a way on their farms, I think they can be as efficient and successful on a smaller scale.
This is much easier said than done. As Lisa recognizes, smaller farms will have to get bigger in order to stay competitive. No matter how efficient they are at their scale of production, they're unable to perform like the big farms do.
I kind of sometimes feel that you have to grow to stay competitive, but I don't foresee us ever milking 1,000 cows on this farm. We kind of like it the size it is as far as the number of employees we have and how we manage it. We like to keep it family. If you get much larger than that, it requires a lot more employees. I'm sure we'll get bigger. The only pressure you feel with having a neighbor larger farm is land. A lot of the larger farms can pay a high price for land, and without the acreage, we can't grow the crops to feed our animals. We have all the same equipment that all the big, larger farms do, but it's more on a smaller scale.
In order to preserve their farm, Hilton Dairy approaches these pressures and challenges with calm optimism about the future, but nonetheless, the challenges remain. Although Hilton Farms has developed ways to overcome pressures to update operations today, in time, the farm will face a point where they have to expand. The demands of the industry have gradually transformed the family farm into a business.
Standing there at the remains of a high school football game, and it don't do me.